you know, if you think about just a lay person and what they spend most of their time thinking about, it's people. And so as a social psychologist in particular, you know, I can't think of a discipline that, you know, could be more relevant to our everyday lives. Understanding people and why we do the things we do, understanding behavior and thought processes, those questions in and of themselves are really exciting.
Psychology is the scientific study of behaviors and mental processes. Behaviors and mental processes is what we do, what we do and what our friends do and what our loved ones do, and in order to be able to say I think that I have fun with psychology, what that means is that I'm starting to understand things a lot better about why I do certain things. Another aspect of our department, which is really quite different from a lot of others, is that we have things called track concentrations. We have four of them. We have three graduate programs, and what this allows is for undergraduates to be taught by graduate faculty and to not only get a degree in psychology, either a Bachelor of Arts or a Bachelor of Science degree in psychology, but also to basically concentrate in a particular area of study. The four we have right now tracks are clinical psychology and industrial organizational psychology and the psychology of addictions and also behavioral neuroscience.
It's a really exciting major because, well, it's so broad. You can do lots of different things with your bachelor's degree. You can go on and work in human resources, business, work for a not-for-profit, or work in social services or human services. Or you can take the graduate school path and go on in psychology. We have students who go on in law, medicine. We even have students who go on in other health disciplines like OT and PT. So there's just a variety of things that a student can do in psychology.
So there's opportunities to get involved not only with working with people and doing sort of perceptual experiments or social cognition experiments, but also working with animals in the laboratory to understand sort of the psychophysiology of processes that are going on. As you combine sort of the benefits of having a research-focused big institution that has lots of connections in an urban setting with the medical school and the other professional school and political and business enterprises in the city, but also that sort of small school feel that the faculty are approachable, they're not going to sort of gruffly tell you to go away and leave them alone. Undergraduate education is one of our priority goals here.
To be able to do research here at IUPUI is just, it's an amazing experience that I think it's irreplaceable. I'll be starting my seventh research project, so I've had lots of opportunities. I've worked on many different projects. They've ranged from looking at actually undergraduate research, like trying to assess the benefits of it, and all the way to looking at clinical treatments for integrated dual disorders, and also looking at goals.
So they know how to find information, they know how to make evidence-based decisions, they know how to look at data and decide, you know, what's the best course of action here. And that course of action doesn't have to be in research, it could be in counseling, it could be in teaching, it could be in business, it could be in a number of different kinds of careers.
We've created sort of a little community here and a little family. And we have lots of opportunities for students to be engaged right here in psychology, which will make this big environment seem small.
It kind of has a small college atmosphere around here. We definitely know our students by name and face.
There's an open door policy with every teacher that I have. Basically, if you ever want to talk, if you have a question, if you just want to stop in and chat with someone about anything, there's always an open door policy, and you can always walk in at any time and ask any question, and they're very open and they never make you feel like you're asking a dumb question, even though you might be asking a dumb question.
I really found that I love being in the classroom. I like working with students in an educational mode like the classroom. It gives me a chance to get them excited about material maybe they haven't been exposed to before. Gives me a chance to explain things to them in ways that they maybe haven't heard before. And just the interaction with the students I find very rewarding, actually.
I mean, it's really the best deal for the experience you're gonna gain. With a psychology department, the reason why I don't feel like I'm a number is because the faculty are really good advocates. I haven't really needed an advocate in the sense that I've gotten in trouble or I've had issues. It's more so when I do things, they get recognized.
The psychology students at IUPUI are actually a pretty tight group. Since I've been here, I've actually really found a kind of a niche, if you will. At IUPUI, the students, we all know each other in the School of Science, especially psychology. The one thing about IUPUI that I like more than anything else is how informative IUPUI is. I feel like I've been hand-fed exactly, okay, you want to succeed, here's the formula to succeed.
I think that IUPUI has I think it's just the environment here, the opportunities that are available, and really just, I think the faculty and the academics really make this school. Coming from a different university and then also having an experience here, I think this experience is so much richer and you just gain so much more knowledge and hands-on experience that I don't know if you can gain that at other universities.
Department is we really are strong on undergraduate education and training. We have lots of resources available to students. I think the faculty are committed to teaching. They're also committed to research as well, and the blending of their research and teaching is a wonderful mix for students to learn about. We have other resources as well. We have a good advising program, so undergraduate students can get help. I think as they're trying to figure out, what do I want to do, what courses do I want to take, these kinds of things. There's just a very rich environment.
I think it all starts with the people. I mean, I think anywhere that's the case, and I think that the people here, I think that their work speaks for itself, and I think that the metrics of the school speak for itself too. But I think most of all it's the people, and I think that anyone who is a prospective student that gets the chance to really interact with some of the faculty here or even some of the other, you know, students or, you know, mentors, advisors, I think that they're all outlets where the department can really amplify, you know, its strengths.